Hello friends, welcome to Fortify Solution. Now today in this tutorial, we'll see how to make a stopwatch. Now as you can see in this screen, we have a stopwatch and it's running. And we'll create a similar stopwatch and we'll see what are the codes to be used for that. And so how we'll proceed? First we'll create turtle and then we'll create this turtle screen and then we'll give the title name, say stopwatch, or you can the screen name. Then we'll create this watch window or rectangular. Then we will create three variables. That's one variable for hour, second variable for minutes, third variable for seconds. Now you can see that after just crossing the 60 seconds, this minute will increase. So definitely we'll provide one logical loop. And for that we'll define functions and we use while loop also. So let's start. First, as we says, we'll create this create turtle and screen, and we'll create this background, and slowly we'll move ahead. Okay. So first, you go to this file and click on new. Sorry, not this one. I said file. Go to new, and create Python file. Give your name, what you wish. In this case, I already created. So I'll start with the import first. So first we have to write import and then turtle. As we are using time, so definitely we should import time module also. Okay, now once then we create turtle. Let's say t is equal to turtle dot turtle, turtle. And we create a turtle screen also, say turtle dot screen. Now as I said that we will create this title as a stopwatch. So what we'll do, we'll say s dot title, yeah, and then we give the title name, say stopwatch, and we create background color also. Let's say s dot bg color, and we'll say black. Okay, and okay, black has to be inverted column. Yeah, and we'll say our window should be remain open. So we say title turtle done. So let's see whatever we have done. It's so for that we have to go run, click on run and Fortify. So see, as you can see, we have this turtle, because turtle also by default is in black in color, so we can't see black because our screen is in black color with this command. And we given turtle title as a stopwatch. You can see here the stopwatch. So now we have to change the turtle color also. So what we do, t dot pen color, pen color, let's say white. So we will run again. Now you can see our turtle at origin or at the center at this moment. Okay, now we have to create two variables. As I said, that's one variable for minute, second is for hour, and third variable for seconds. So let's start. Say second underscore count. Just I'm giving the variable name, and initially I'm putting zero. And similarly, we'll make for minutes also. Minute count, and I'll give zero value initially. And then lastly r underscore count, and I'll give the variable zero. Okay, now what we'll do, now we'll define layout, because define a function called layout, because if you recall that we have to draw a rectangular, in that we have to specify what is r, what is minutes, and what is second. So I'll just go back and run the previous file, what what we are at now doing. So as you have seen, we have created this screen, we had given title stopwatch. Now we are creating this rectangular box, and in that we'll write this hour, minutes and second. So that's why we says we define a layout. Okay, so in this layout, and first we says total dot pen up, because okay, and then let's say total dot pen size, and we'll make it 3 pixel, so the layout width, the rectangular width should be more. Now we'll say that it go to -80, 100, and total dot pen color. Pen color color different, but anyway, we'll run it again. It's white, and pen color we have given white color. Okay, and then once this is done, then we says t dot write, and says we the title stop watch, and I want font to be around 25. Okay, so let's see what we did. I'll run this layout, and I'll run, sorry, not this main, we have a 45, so we have to select 45 solutions, and I'll run. Now see, so what we did, we have called this layout function, we says pen size 3, and then we says total go to this location, so it went to that location and says color white and says stopwatch. This is what he wrote. Now we have to draw a now rectangular. So we'll says t total go to -100 and by 40. Okay, now I'll tell you why. Total dot pen down double colon. Now there are 2-3 ways we can create that rectangular. So to make it shorter program, I use the for loop for I in range of 2. So I'm just calling this for loop by twice, and in that I'm saying total dot forward, and I'll say is move go to 140, then I say total dot right and 90 degree, and then I guess the total dot forward, and then you move around 55, and then again you t dot right right, and I move 90 degree. So I think so by this recall we can able to create this rectangular. Let's run and see. So we had a fantastic, we have created the second screen. Now we have to write the this, what we can say, we have to give the what hours and seconds and minutes. So I'll say t dot pen up, because now we have to move our coordinates, or we have to move the turtle to a particular location. Then I say t dot go to -70, 0. Okay, why I'm doing actually, now see, we have created this rectangular. Now I wanted 0 to be at this location, and then my that is hour, then second minutes, and then second. So definitely I have to move that particular the distance to be traveled. So that for that purpose I'm using this -40. I'm making the turtle to go to over there, and using pen up so that they won't draw any line. If suppose I won't write this, I'll show you what exactly. We'll see over there, and it's now my cursor was over here, and I, when I says the turtle go to -70, 0, so straight away while going you draw that line, which I don't want, because this is what we are not looking for, to draw this line. So I'll say pen up. Once I do pen up, it won't draw, but straight away will go to that particular location. So now my turtle in that location, I'll say t dot
pen color says green. Okay, and then I'll says p dot pen down, and I say p dot write. And now, as you can say, we have to write R. So I'll just call the function R, and I want that font to be 25, because I already try and tested. So I'll show you, I'll run it again for you. See what we did, we have created a circle now, and over here we have turtle, and we says 25 font ka this 0 why we have, because initially we have given, we have created a three variables, seconds, minutes and hour, and we initialize the value with 0. So what happened, the very first we says R count, so that what we have called here, it's, and we, sorry, over here, and we say the count which is 0 at its value. Now what we do, we says turtle dot pen up. Now we have to move to next location, pen up, and then what we do, this is t to turtle go to, now next location is suppose is minus 45 and 0, and again I says pen t dot pen down, and I says t dot write. Now what I do, I'll make a double colon, and I'll write font to be 25. Okay, now why I did actually, we have created, now we have 0, and you can see this double colon, so that's good. It's all about appearance. For appearance purpose only, we are just putting that double colon, so it bifurcate with the seconds and minutes. Okay, now what we'll do again, this is t dot pen up, pen up, and then I says t dot go to minus 35 and 25. It is a coordinate actually, so because previously I already created, so I know which coordinate to be given for that particular write up, so that it appear exact location. So t dot write, and I'll says hh, and okay, so what we did, I'll just run it again. We have created, we said okay, you can see that hh appear over here. Okay, so actually it's not, it should be mm, it has to be mm. Now for hh, what we miss out, it should be here, just I'll put it, I'll say t to go to bracket minus 70 comma 25, because just about this 0 we should write t dot write double colon hh. I'll just run it again. See, here we have hh and we have minute. Now we have to write 0 over here. For that we have to call the minutes function. So mm, after that I'll say you should t to go to minus 35 comma 0 and t dot pen down. Okay, and we have to write now. So what I'll do, I'll straight away now copy this. I'll copy from here till the end, because it's a repetitive, we have a lot of repetitive. So I'll straight away copy paste. Okay, I'll put a space in that so that we can forget what we copy paste. So we turn down again. Now we have to again write. Now in this case we have to say minute count again found with 25, and then again say pen up. And now we have to write it for the second. I'll just run it again. You can see. So
now we have turtle over here. This says turtle go to this location, and before going to this location, draw double colon here, and write over here SS and give the and call the second, which is a zero at this moment. Okay, so we'll say we have done with this. This is panel. Now we have to move this turtle. So go to and then pen down, then double colon 25 found, then again pen up, and then again go to says 35 over here. So it says 5 and 25. We keep this is 5 and keep 25 up there. And now in this case, I'll put SS, and this again I'll put 5 and pen down. And we have to, okay, let's see how what we have done now. So we have to call that second function, pen down, and this is t dot write, and second, we should have to call that function second count comma font to be 25. I'll see. So but only that color difference we have, that is it's not white in color. So later onwards I'll do it. And we have created our stopwatch. Now this stopwatch to be workable, so how to make it workable, or the second to be move, and moment the second reaches to 60 second, the minute should be converted into one, and once this minute comes or becomes your 60, then automatically should again convert into 0, and this R should be become 1. So now we have to create a logic, simple maths logic actually. So now we have done with this layout. So now we create another function. We have to define another function that says seconds, and I'll just double colon. Now what we do, now you can see we have to make a, in that we want that our loop should, or this stopwatch should work continuously until unless we physically cancel or stop this second or stop this program. For that we should use while loop, because it run until unless someone interrupt or the situation become false. So I'll use the while loop, and I'll say second count plus or equals to 1. Okay, and now we call this second function under this variable. So in this variable we have to pass 3 more variables. So what we have to do, we have to pass that r underscore count, then minute underscore count, count, and then seconds, what we are use in this second underscore count, count. Okay, so that red. Okay, now we already imported time function. Now say time sleep for 1 second. After 1 second, you should, what to do, you should write twri, write what second, and we already given found equals to 25. Okay, so what we did actually, so I'll do one thing after this layout, I'll call this seconds also, seconds, and we have to call this throughput of variable also, because I'll just run it again. So it's done, you can see, but it's overlay, but it's not erased. See, it's writing over there. So we have to refresh, or what to do, we have to just before writing it should do undo, t dot undo. So before, it should erase whatever previously wrote in that particular location. So now you can see, in every after 1 second our stopwatch is working. So but
we have only just says count. We have not defined the now logics. Now in this case, what happened? We have to define logic that after reaching a 60 second, it should increase the minute value from 0 to 1. Now for that, what we use the if condition. Okay, now if means you keep on adding this second count, and what if second count become greater or equals to 60, then what to do? Then it should increase the minute count by 1, and again second count should become 0. Okay, and once it done, then what to do? We call our layout function layout. Okay, because we want to refresh our layout. So I'll just run it again and see, are we are going right track or not? Okay, now what I do, because for we have to wait 60 seconds, it is little bit longer second time. So what we do, I'll just reduce to 5 seconds. Okay, what I'm saying that a moment our second count reaches 5, it jumps to, it triggers this if condition, and as per if condition, the minutes, my minutes goes to become 1 and second count becomes 0, and then again I'm calling my layout. So let's see how it's behave now. So after waiting for 5 seconds, 5, and again, see now what we did, what mistake we are doing, we're calling this layout, but not, we are not refreshing the variable that initially what we have given this 00. So for that, what we have to do in the layout function itself, we have to paste this 3 variable, we have to pass these parameters, or you can 3 arguments. So once we pass these arguments or parameters, and in that also we have to pass, and in this layout also we have to put. Now what happened, moment we call this layout, it will call this r count. Now in this r count still is 0, but in minutes count, now its new value is 1, and second count is new value is 0. Okay, and when we call the layout, we want layout whatever previously we have created should be clean. So in the very first beginning itself is write clean function. So whenever my this function new layout layout is called, it will straight away clean the previous layout and then rewrite all this, and while rewriting all this, it will take this r value or this minute value, or you can say revise r and minute value. Now let's see it's working or not. We have to wait for 5 seconds. 3, 4, 5, and again hold. Now see, my minutes become 0 to 1. Again 2, and again it's counting. So it's now similar. Now we have in the very first condition we have created the if condition till minutes. Now similarly we have to put for the our condition also for our. Now for our, what we have to do, again after we are saying if minutes count is greater or equals to 60, then what to do? Then I says r count should increase by 1, and minute count should become 0, and second count as usual has to again restart, so becomes 0. Okay, and after becoming after re, what you say is give becoming the revised value, again we have to call this layout function in which we'll pass these 3 parameters. Okay, so and I'll do one thing again, I'll again reduce this value, second says 3, and I'll make it says 5 seconds. No, again make it
3, so that we won't have to wait for full 60 seconds. So once it's become 3, it will refresh the whole layout. Okay, need to refresh the whole layout. Now it's become 2. Once it become 3, see, once it become 3, now see R value. So I think so we are done with this. Only the minor correction we have to do is, first we have to erase this turtle, and this H2 should be in green in color. So that also we can do. To remove that turtle, what we do is, at the beginning or before this define function, we say turtle dot hide. So we can't see a turtle. And what we are saying, before this H, we have defined this. So what we have to do, taking this line before writing this T. Okay, and you can see the refresh is a little bit slow. So what we'll do, we say turtle dot speed, and we'll give the maximum value 0, and let's see. Now you can see how smoothly is working. So, and after becoming 3, and now see it become. So I think guys, you understood very well. My main function was or my importance was just that you should understand the concept. So I guess you understood, and I'll just correct this seconds because it has to be 60 seconds if your watch should be work accurately. Okay, so I think so we're done. What we are at the beginning, we said that we'll create a stopwatch, and I think successfully we have created a stopwatch. It working fantastically, and definitely we can shrink our code. We have to become more smarter, and we have to use more other conditions like if loops, or you can say that while loops we can use, and we can shrink our codes. So that's it guys for this video. I think so you enjoyed. So if you have any queries, please put your queries in my comments section, and I'll definitely respond you back. So take care. Rab rakha.